On the Medical Watch for you this evening, combining gaming technology with medicine.
It is becoming a great training tool for surgeons before they put their skills to work. WGN's Dina Baer explains.
On the Medical Watch, gaming technology enters the operating room. A local doctor is using augmented reality to sharpen his visuals during spine procedures, and he says it's a game changer.
Dr. Frank Phillips has a new tool on his belt. As he suits up, he fiddles with the gear that includes a headset.
It's like a natural extension of all these video games, you know, virtual reality, augmented reality. It's going to be used in the operating room.
But spine surgery is no game. Every move counts.
All right, are we ready?
Surgeons regularly rely on intraoperative x-rays, CT scans, and navigation systems to help guide their procedure. But Dr. Phillips says this system, which uses augmented reality, is next level.
So when you look through the headset, looking down at the patient's back, you get the CT images that we're used to from navigation, and then at the same time, it projects an augmented three-dimensional view of the spine. So you're actually through the skin looking at the spine. So it's truly x-ray vision.
Called X-Vision, the system allows the Midwest Orthopedics at Rush surgeon to see the patient's spine image in a heads-up display, meaning in his field of vision, he doesn't have to turn away to view the anatomy on a separate monitor.
I mean, the augmented reality system's really game-changing. It really gives you the best of all worlds.
He practiced on cadaver models before using the technology on Honore Murillo in mid-June.
He explained it, and he's like, I got this cool technology, and I go, sure. I'm like, whatever it's going to take.
It wasn't Honore's first procedure. She's had 23 surgeries since she was hit by a speedboat in 1996. The accident destroyed her upper leg and left her with several broken ribs and an unstable spine.
I have numbness and tingling in both legs, so it was at the point where I couldn't walk, and I was stumbling a lot and tripping and falling down the stairs.
Her latest procedure, a minimally invasive multi-level spinal fusion using the augmented reality system.
Afterwards in the hospital, like all the doctors came in and were like, you've got to see this. Like everybody's coming. This was like so cool.
The 51-year-old is walking regularly as part of her recovery, and she says she feels a sense of pride knowing she was among the very first patients to help launch a new generation of tech in surgery.
I've been through so much, and I feel like if this is like anything I can do to help with the community and give back a little bit, you know, being in pain like that and suffering like that, it's a horrible experience. Like, nobody wants to go through that.
Dr. Phillips says virtual reality will ultimately provide real benefits to patients.
So being more efficient, quicker, more accurate, less muscle damage because we're more precise with placing all these instruments, I think it will add real benefits to patients.
Dr. Phillips believes the advanced gaming technology will eventually be applied to a range of surgeries, not just spine procedures. Back to you.